Greetings for the day from Umadevi Children's Academy. This is Vikas Gupta, your class 8th computer teacher. So today we are going to learn about our chapter number 5, that is app development. So this chapter we shall be covering in 2 sessions. So this is our first session. So in the first session we will learn about introduction to apps, types of apps, classification of mobile apps and use of common apps. Okay, so before we start, let's ensure that you are sitting in a quiet place, you are in the proper network, you are having a stationery with you, you have put your cell phone in landscape mode and you are wearing a headphone. So just ensure all these things. Now let's start. So dear students, the chapter number 5, app development. So first of all, we are going to learn about introduction to apps. Okay, so the word app is an abbreviation for application. Okay, so an application is a software designed to do a specific job. An app enables you to do something specific, like you can paint, draw, read maps and barcodes, take photographs, play games, watch and edit videos, and a host of other activities. But within the technical limitations of your device, however, the rapid rise in the use of smartphones these days, the word app is mostly used to refer to the software that runs on mobile phones. Since smartphones, tablets, and other mobile devices are nothing but small computers, an app works in pretty much the same way as the software does on a desktop or laptop. Since the computing power and memory of a smartphone are generally less than that of a standalone computer, the capability of the app are generally less than that of a similar software running on a computer. Most desktops do not have touch screen capabilities, while all mobile devices have touch screens. This changes the way the user interacts with the device. Instead of a keyboard and a mouse, the user taps on the display, which works both as an input as well as an output device. So apps are designed to work on different operating systems used by the various devices. An Android app is developed to work on phones and tablets, which runs on Android OS operating system, whereas iPhone apps can be used on iPhone, which use iPhone operating system, okay, iOS. For better running of apps, the internet connection speed must be fast so that the app can be downloaded easily from the Google Play Store on Android phone or through App Store on iOS. So dear students, there are some types of apps. Apps can be broadly classified as desktop apps, web apps and mobile apps. Desktop apps. These apps can be used on a desktop or laptop. Generally, they do not need web access and run independently on a computer. To run a desktop app, it must first be installed on the desktop or laptop. The installed app is represented either by an icon on the computer screen or an item on the start menu. Example of the desktop applications are word processor, spreadsheet, paint and notepad. You know very well about them. Next, web apps. These apps require an internet connection. They are usually browser based and stored on a remote server. Users access them like any other web page and then install them on their computer by creating a bookmark to that page. Web applications require minimum device memory as the application lies on the remote server. These applications can be utilized at whatever point needed from any device through the internet. For example, Google Maps, Instant Messenger, etc. There is the third one type, mobile apps. These apps run on smartphone or or a tablet. You know very well about them. You are using them also. Mobile apps have responsive web design to adapt to the much smaller screen sizes and orientations of the mobile devices. These apps are usually smaller in size as mobile devices have limited memory. Some mobile apps may come preloaded on cell phones or tablets. Keeping in view the device independence feature, software companies nowadays make diverse versions of the applications to be used as desktop apps, web apps or mobile apps. Means to say, the companies are now keeping in mind that the same app they are designing for desktop, it should be on the web also and it should be for available for mobile also. Okay, so look at here, one list is given. There are some softwares, photo editing software, Facebook, Office Suite and games. So each of the software is having their desktop app, web app and mobile app. Okay, so you have to just read about them. Okay, so just you have to pause the video, read about them, and after reading then you will play the video. So read, stop the video and play. So just pause the video and read them. So dear students, I hope you have read very well about them. Now there are some two more softwares are given here, media players and maps. So I want to tell you that there are media players that are installed, VLC player and Windows media player installed in our desktop. Okay, and we are having many websites that offer to listen music, okay, to watch TV. Okay, like this we are having some mobile apps also for playing the media. Okay, so there are maps also, map software, Google Maps, this is a desktop software also, we can use its web version also, and we are having its mobile app also. So now classification of mobile apps. Mobile apps can be further classified as native apps or hybrid apps. Now what is native apps and hybrid apps? Native apps means mobile apps are usually developed for a specific operating system and device. This is because each device may have different specification like GPS, dual SIM, camera, memory, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi or NFC. So apps that are developed keeping the device specification in mind are known as native apps. Most native apps come pre-installed on the new phone and can also be downloaded from the Play Store or App Store and further installed on the device. Some native apps can run on the device without the use of the internet, but others may need the internet facility for full functionality. These apps have certain limitations. They are designed for a particular platform and are expensive to develop and maintain. Hybrid apps. Hybrid apps contain the feature of both the web apps and native apps. These apps can be downloaded from the Play Store or App Store and installed on the device. These apps require the device to be connected to the internet. Hybrid apps can be stored partly on the local device and partly on the remote server. Okay, on both. Some hybrid apps can be operated offline also by using cached pages. However, they have limited functionality offline. For example, the most popular gaming app Candy Crush is a hybrid app that can be played on a mobile phone as well as on the web. So there are some uses of common apps. Apps have become so prevalent today that a suitable one can be found for almost any job. Whether it is for learning, entertainment, social interactions or even banking and e-commerce, there is an app for every purpose. Okay, so there are two types of apps. So there are two apps given here, educational apps and social networking apps. So there are some educational apps. With the rapid increase of mobile technology, learning with apps have become fun. There is a rapid spread of education to the remotest corners of the world. Today, students in the far-flung villages can easily access the high-quality educational resources. There are apps for all levels of learning. Apps not only help us to learn new concepts, but also shows us what is being taught in the classroom. Students of all age groups can access a treasure chest of information on any topic. Educational apps are equally useful for both students and teachers. Teachers are able to distribute study material quickly, conduct tests, and grade the students efficiently by using apps like Google Classroom, okay, Kahoot, etc. So parents do make use of educational apps to interact more closely with the teachers and thus monitor the progress of their children. In keeping with this trend, many online study resources like Khan Academy, Byju's learning app, as well as online study platforms like edX and Coursera are now available via apps. Social networking. In a word that is increasingly social and open, social media plays a significant role in communication. Social media apps let you post images, videos, and other updates to your profile, which can be shared with anyone. You can connect with anyone across the globe easily via such apps. There are several types of social networking apps available today. Some of the most popular social networking apps are listed below. Look at here, we are having WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and some more are here. Instagram, LinkedIn, Reddit, Snapchat. Okay, so many social networking apps are there. So we will learn them in our next session. Okay, in the session number 2 of this chapter. So dear students, this is the end of the session number 1. So the homework for this session is, if you are having any left work of your chapter number 4, so you have to just complete that work within the 7 days. Okay, so I wish you all the best. By the way, keep on learning. Bye bye. Have a great day ahead.